This video tutorial I will explain update user details API endpoint. Here I have defined a class user controller. It has update user method which accept user ID and user details request model object. And here you can see the path parameter ID, and this value will be assigned to this user ID. And this method consumes either XML or JSON and produces either XML or JSON. And here I am checking the user details object as email, and if it is empty, then it throws exception. And here I am creating a user rest object, then I am creating a user DTO object, then I am copying user details property values to user DTO object, then I am calling update user method of user service object by passing user ID and user DTO object, and this method is responsible for updating the user information based on the user ID, and this method returns user DTO object. Then I am copying user DTO object property values to user rest properties. Then I am returning the user rest object to the client. Update user method will be there in user service interface. Here you can see. And this method is abstract method. And this method implementation will be there in user service imbl class. And here you can see, in this method what I am doing is, based on user ID, I am getting a user entity object from the users table. And if user entity object is not there, then it throws exception. And if user entity object is there, then I am setting the first name, last name and email from user DTO to user entity object, and also the password. Then I am calling save method of user repository object to update the user information. And this method returns user entity object. Then I am copying user entity object property values to user DTO object. Then returns user DTO object to the controller layer. Now I am starting the application in debug mode. Now I am going to send request to login URL to get the token, and in the body I am passing email and the password. Click on send, and 200 OK, request is successful. Click on headers, and here we got the user ID and the token, JWT token. Copy the user ID. And to update user, we have to use this URL, and at the end we have to pass the user ID, and HTTP method should be put, and copy the token. And add authorization header. Paste the value. And in the body, I am sending first name, last name, email address and the password. And in database, last name is D. And I want to change to last name as John. Change as John. Click on send. And request reached here. and here we got the output, and the last name is successfully updated as John. Refresh, and here you can see the last name is successfully updated. Next we will send invalid user ID and we will see what happens. Click on send. And it will throw user service exception with record not found message. And here we got status as 500 internal server error, and error ID is 201, and here we got the message. Record with provided ID is not found. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.